Hey y'all, welcome to the guitar talk today. I wanted to talk about the Kramer and just, you know, my thoughts and opinions, experience, and just overall conversation about it to, you know, put it out there because, you know, I've been working a lot with it lately and been able to do a few things. I thought it'd just be nice to kind of put something together and kind of go over certain things that I've done, worked with, and, you know, something that you might have questions about. But anyways, first thing I did was the graphtech ratio tuners, and I end up working with the D tuna. Overall, most of the stuff, if you follow the Facebook page under G-Man Evans, there's a post about it, pictures, talks about it, and that kind of, you know, where everything ends up falling towards. But for here, we're gonna at least do the video so we can cover that. Overall, it's a nice guitar, plays great, worked well out of the box, of course, outside of the issue of getting one in with a broken headstock, but the neck is great, frets are good, very level and smooth. I haven't had any issues, minor adjustments. I think I did maybe a minor neck adjustment after the fact, but just to kind of get it to where I wanted my preference, and the levels, the intonation, everything's right on, and it holds up well. But to start with the graphtech ratio tuners, end up putting those on because I just didn't like the stock die-cast tuners. Didn't have a lot to offer working with them. They weren't very responsive. So dealing with that, especially on a new string change, you have to do that back and forth. Beginning from stringing it up, getting it set up there, getting it kind of where you want it and making your adjustments as you're stretching everything in before you lock it down, of course. It's just my personal preference and choice is having the locking tuners because I could string the guitar right up, lock it down, and then get it to where I want with good responsiveness all the way until the strings are ready to be locked down. And of course, knowing Floyd Rose, sometimes it needs adjustments as you play on, and you know, weather, temperatures, anything could, you know, change things up where it needs minor adjustments over time. So if you need to take it off, you can make a quick adjustment a lot easier and faster before you lock it back down again. And it's just, again, a personal choice and preference that I think was a good one, good investment, and holds up really well. So, you know, with the if you're not familiar with graphtech tuners, they come with like four different bass plates. So they're capable to fit on a variety of guitars without having to do any kind of drilling and situation like that. So like that, for this one, it fit pretty much right over place and didn't have any issues going into the spots with the stock screws. Or at least the stock screw holes. I did use the stock screws because they were black. The ones they come with were chrome, and the plates that they come with are unpainted aluminum stamped. I went ahead and painted these just with spray paint because it's minimal, easy, simple, and it does the job. And it matches the whole aspect a lot better. So you could do that and work with it pretty well. Of course, with the reverse headstocks, you're going to order the left-hand tuners, because that's just the ones that will fit. And again, yeah, fit no issues, right on, easy and good. So worth the investment, good choice. And any questions on that, you're welcome to, you know, ask, and we can get more in depth on that. But that just pretty much covers why I did it for myself and why I put it on there overall. The next thing I did was work with the D tuna. I had ordered the D tuna for this because a lot of the Kramers and the graphic series, if you look on their order sites, anywhere from Kramer's website to all the big box stores, Sweetwater Musician's Friend, Zounds, all those, they are listed as, or at least the picture showed that they used to come with the D-Tuna already installed, and it has a trim stop. These, one of these LRT something 40 trim stops. I put a nut on this one to help it kind of stabilize. But they said in their descriptions that at least includes the trim stop, and the description no longer includes that it includes the detuna. So you got back and forth on that. So what you're going to probably expect to get when you order one is you're not going to get a detuna. You're not going to get a trim stop. Didn't have one at all. Of course, that's what it looks like in the back. And it did not come with one whatsoever. I tried to email and talk to some, you know, Kramer themselves, which is, of course, Gibson, and then a couple other people from the stores online, and try to see what they can do, see about supplying me one. If they end up sending something, then they'll send it, but I don't think they're going to do anything like that. But it, still, when you want to get a detuna, of course, you want one with a trim that is above the body. You don't want one that's recessed in because it won't fit. It'll extend past that and won't be able to work with that in the cavity. But I tried to put it on and it worked well. It's just I didn't like a couple things about it. For one, when I had the stock tuners on and trying to get the strings settled in well, I'll have it on. And if the strings aren't locked down yet, I can get it fine-tuned and set up so where it's in, you know, D, put it to E, and then it'll be in tune and play. But if I did a hard bend on it or any kind of really bend on that low E, it will go, I think it went flat. So it'll knock itself out of tune. And it's funny, is like if you put it back out and in and kind of, you know, jig around with it, it gets back in tune. No problem, but anytime you do the bend, it's off. So it's kind of just a weird thing that it did. Of course, I haven't tested it with the new tuners because I took it off. I was kind of on and off and on and off with it. And right now it's currently off. Because the other main problem I had is that I do like the full floating capability of the Floyd Rose. I did do some pull-ups and the dive bombs. But even when I had it in and all put together, you know, if I can get by without having the pull-up capability, you got to set up either way how you mount it. And I didn't like mounting it in the middle because you had to either move the springs, switch them around, adjust them, or put them down to just two. Or you could put three on there, you know, with one on the side, or even four. But four, of course, was going to be way too unresponsive. It didn't work very well as you want to use the trim four. And then with the three and doing all that, it worked okay. But it, depending on how you set it up, where, you know, you could normally push the trim back farther in to get more a tighter response as you normally should, putting the trim stop on there because you want it to hold the tuning, of course, as you get it set up. And let's see, what it did was when you get it set up on there, you could have it in there. And of course it made it a little bit stiffer, which I didn't like. I just liked the more comfortable natural state. You know, you could sit there and do your dive bombs. And if you go back up, it'll be where it is. Sometimes when you play, I noticed that if you have too few springs or not enough tension on it, it'll kind of vibrate on the back of the trim stop. And even with putting a little bit of something in there to soften that, it had an extra weird vibration in the body that kind of just was annoying and noticeable. Not necessarily plugged up, but it was just things that I noticed back and forth dealing with the you know, the whole setup on it. But when it was locked down and set up and working, the detuner worked great. Had it set up right, and it did what it was supposed to. So I did like it. And I may put it back on, of course, because, you know, I still have it and I'm going to work with it. But for this point in time, or everything I'm doing at this is all at this point in time. So I'm going to continue working with it and do different things. But this is just, you know, what I've done so far. And, you know, this is just what we're going to talk about at this time. But for the point now that I have is it's not on. And I like it for, you know, what it is and the simple setup. So, yeah, when it comes back on, maybe we'll do another episode talking about that and then go from there. But it's, you know, good guitar. Good guitar, plays right, does everything that it needs to do. I think it's a, you know, a great setup for what it offers at the price point. You know, you got your Seymour Duncan, JB, Floyd Rose 1000 series. You know, and do a small investment, some good tuners of your choice and your liking, and you got a great setup overall. But yeah, just keep in touch on that. If any questions, let me know. You know, what I covered, what I didn't cover, and what things you might want to know about the guitar, the setups, D-Tuna, the gear ratio tuners, graphtech, hell, anything. Because I think it's just nice to be able to talk about it sometimes. It's basically like a vlog, podcasts, a little bit of everything in one. It's just my way of kind of reaching out there and doing something that I don't normally do. So maybe if, you know, something like this works, I'll continue doing something more like that, because I think it's nice to be able to cover a lot. I've got a good collection of guitars and good things that I'm always working on, because I'm always playing something, I'm always working on something. You know, I don't necessarily, I'm not like a luthier, I don't get on there and tear shit apart and put it all back together, but I like to work things as I can and want to, and I'm always looking to stuff up, so I'm curious about it just like anybody else is. But either way, that's the situation for today. If you watched all the way through, I appreciate you. If not, do like I do, just kind of fast forward to the parts that you want to figure out. But everything's kind of random today. Nothing's really in order. It's just what I wanted to talk about, like a podcast. It's just kind of an open-ended conversation. So thanks for joining in on it. And, you know, we'll catch it on the next round. See ya.